Tune into this week's on.NET, where I have my good friend Katie Savage on, talking about the .NET coding pack, the easiest way to get started learning C# and building apps with .NET. Whether you're a student, a teacher, or just getting started, you're definitely going to want to check this out. So tune in. Everyone, I'm James Montemagno, and I'm back with another on.NET video, this time talking about the easiest way to get started learning C# and building applications with .NET. I have one of my best friends in the entire world, Katie Savage, on. How's it going, Katie?
Hi, I'm flattered.
Katie and I work together every single day, and you have a really cool journey to your life and job here at Microsoft. Do you want to talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, sure. So I'm actually a recent graduate. I've been out of school about 6 to 8 months now. But before that, I interned at Microsoft with the MakeCode team. So I kind of got my entry into the education space and the tech space kind of early. Once I graduated, I came on to James's team, the .NET community team, with a real focus on education. So I really want to support students, new developers, and educators in our space, the .NET environment.
Yeah. So if you're seeing any cool tweaks to the website or documentation, that's all Katie. She did it all.
Well, I did parts, little parts, supported by all you great people.
team effort. Now, this topic is actually really interesting because, you know, I think I've been a .NET developer for like ever, and it's almost automatic for me to know what to install, where to go, how to get started. Jamie Singleton has a great video, like all the learning resources. I'll put that up over here on YouTube or down in the show notes everywhere else. But you actually work on a really cool project called the .NET Coding Pack. What is that?
Yeah, so something I hear a lot from students and can attest to myself is that setting up your coding environment is really tricky. You never know what you're supposed to get and how to get it. So the .NET Coding Pack is a great experience because it's one download that gives you Visual Studio Code, the .NET SDK within that environment, as well as a bunch of extensions to really get you started with .NET without all the craziness of searching around for what you need. And the cool thing is all of these different extensions will update automatically as well.
Oh, cool. So it's like a really like one-click install go is what you're saying.
Exactly. One click, you go through the install process, and boom, it's all there.
So who is this good for? I mentioned, you know, a few different categories, but like, who's the target audience for this coding pack?
This coding pack can really be used by anyone new to .NET, but in particular, students, those who are new to, you know, the tech space generally, and also just tech switchers, and also educators as well, because we have a lot of great notebook experiences that can be customized and used to create, you know, lessons and other learning content.
Oh, cool. I'm really excited to check it out, see how easy it is. I don't think it's ever really been like a one-click install, you know, besides like maybe getting Visual Studio and checking a bunch of checkboxes. So I'm excited to see how this all works. Do you want to show it off?
Yeah, let me show you how it works.
Cool.
All right. So right now I'm in a Windows sandbox, and that really gives me a good experience. It's a nice, clean instance of Windows 11 so that I can kind of show how this experience is going to look for someone who doesn't have any of these tools yet.
Got it.
So first off, I'm on the .NET website, and this is where you're going to get the coding pack and a lot of our other great learning resources. So what I'm going to do here is go to this Learn tab and go to Learn to Code in C#. I actually already have that open in this tab here. And on this page, we just have a bunch of our great C# learning content and tools. So first off, here's our coding pack. As you can see, it's Visual Studio Code with all of those extensions that I mentioned before. So I'll show that off in just a second, but I want to quickly show the other great C# and .NET learning resources we have. So going down a little bit, we have these awesome interactive notebooks for C#. This is a great repository that once we have our VS Code, we can then go into these notebooks and bring them over to VS Code. We also have Microsoft Learn, which has a bunch of great lesson plans. They're very interactive, and they allow you to build basically any kind of app that you could want to build. You could build a web app, a mobile app, et cetera. And all that content is right here. We also have great videos and other resources, but let me get back to the coding pack because that's what we're focused on today. So right here, as you can see, we have a download for Windows and Mac as well. You can also get this on Linux. It's just a little bit of a different process. You're going to need to get VS Code and then the Interactive Notebooks extension for that. But since I'm in Windows, let me go ahead and download that.
So really, you just come to this website and this will be just the latest and greatest version of it, basically?
Exactly. This gets updated anytime the pack itself is updated.
Okay, cool. And I see that's actually really not that big. It's like 40 megabytes, it looks like.
Yeah, not that big at all. And it's a pretty quick process depending on the speed of your machine. So I'm going to go ahead and let that go to work. And it's loading up. But the great thing about this pack is, as I'll show in a bit, once you get everything loaded up, you'll be launched into a getting started experience right off the bat. So not only do you have the whole setup that you need with all the extensions there, but you're going to instantly be put into this learning experience. And there that goes. Minimize this. So the install is ready. So all I have to do is click next, which I'll do right now. Agree to the license agreement, and it's going to start installing.
So this is going to install, like you said, all the bits. I can see it's downloading VS Code, but you said it's also installing .NET in a, like a in a self-contained instance, and then also the extensions, correct?
Exactly. So it's starting with Visual Studio Code. Once that's done, you'll see that pop up on my desktop, actually. Then it'll begin getting the .NET SDK within that. And then all the extensions come after.
Perfect.
Awesome. So it looks like it's all done. So let me launch us into VS Code when I click finish.
Now, like you said, of course, like everyone's machine and internet is going to be a little bit different. You're, of course, sharing your screen over here, so it's going to be a little bit slower. But I know I've ran through this with you, and I think it only took me like a minute or two normally, which is kind of cool. But
yeah, it's usually a pretty quick experience. Yeah, of course, if you're sharing your screen or using something else, it might be a bit slower, but usually pretty quick. And it's launching us right into our getting started with .NET notebook here.
So this is kind of different. Like I am used to installing VS Code and then here's VS Code and that's it. But you're saying some other stuff is happening now.
Exactly. So as you can see on the bottom right, it's kind of installing stuff and we're getting launched right into our getting started notebook here. And I can also kind of give you a brief look at some of these extensions as well. And then I'll get into the notebook. So as you can see, it already installed all of these extensions that we need here. So the .NET extension pack, interactive notebooks, there's support for C Sharp, F Sharp, Jupyter, everything you really need to get started with .NET here.
Let me
open this up as well.
So that's really nice. So automatically, right, you just hit one install and it looked like it was installing just like here's the .NET SDK and VS Code, but actually it like installed all of those different extensions and I'm launched into like an experience where I'm learning is what you're saying.
Exactly. This pack is really an experience for students and beginners so that they don't have to worry about any of that install woes or craziness. They can just do that one download, go through the install process, and they've got it all here. Cool. And as you can see, our notebook started up. So this is a .NET interactive notebook. And here we've got some really good just C# syntax and other content to get people kind of off running with C#. So we have syntax basics, introducing variables. We have some stuff working with strings. And this is just like any other notebook. So I could go ahead and run one of these cells. So I'll do our hello world to get us started on the right foot.
So that's cool because this is actually live code blocks that are editable, basically.
Exactly. So that's running.
And of course, here through the magic of screen sharing, it's going to be super slow for us, of course. But
of course, as it always is. So hello world. I can go in, I can change that. I could say hello, James.
Hello. Got it
again. And boom, there we go. So this is really a great way to get kind of jumped into this experience of working with C#. But it doesn't end here. As I mentioned before, we have a lot of other C# notebooks and learning content that can be brought into this experience. So I'm going to go ahead and show that. So let me go back to my browser. And I'm going to go to the notebooks once again down here.
So there's a whole GitHub repository full of these notebooks. So you get one with it, but you're saying there's like a whole bunch of them.
There's a whole bunch of them. And the cool thing here is that each one of these different notebooks, number one, covers a different topic, but they also have accompanying videos, as well as we've linked in some documentation so that as a learner, you can really go in and get more information to expand upon these learnings. So let's say I wanted to learn about, you know, branches. I could go ahead, click that, and it's going to try to open this in VS Code, which is exactly what we want. So I'm going to open that up. And it's going to open that notebook right here once it's done loading up.
Oh, that's cool. You didn't even have to download anything. You just clicked a link and it like automatically downloaded it to VS Code for you.
Exactly. It's a super streamlined experience. And as you can see, here's that great content. It links to the video here. We have all of this. Once again, I can run it. So as a new learner, I could really come in here and just play around. Like I have some good guidance with all of the content, but I can just go into one of these cells and mess around with some of these little code segments here.
That's really cool. And I like also that there's videos accompanying them. So like if you are more of a interactive visual learner with video content, then you're good to go.
Exactly. We've really thought about how different students have different learning styles, and we want to be able to, you know, support people of all different learning styles. So as you can see, this ran, and we have, as you saw, about 10 notebooks in there. So there's so much content for learning C# and all of the topics associated with that.
Cool.
But further, you can go beyond that and really learn how to make a web app or anything else. And that's where we go to MS Learn, as I mentioned before. So I'm going to go back to our .NET website, go to Learn C#. And I'm going to get started with Microsoft Learn. And this is going to take you to a whole area with a ton of different learning modules, all associated with .NET. So you can really learn how to build anything that you want here.
Oh, awesome.
So this is what that looks like.
Free self-guided learning.
Go ahead.
As all
free self-guided learning paths.
Cool.
Yeah. These are all free. These particular learning paths will have several modules involved. So let's say I wanted to learn how to build a web app with Blazor. I can click on this learning path. It's for beginners. And within this learning path, there's a ton of modules. So there's an introduction, getting started with building, interacting with data, all this awesome content. But since I have my VS Code open, I really want to get to building. I'm just going to skip into our building a web app with Blazor exercise.
So this is cool. So you show that there were notebooks, but then actually you can just take these learn modules and actually build stuff.
Exactly. Exactly. Because we are still within VS Code. So you can really build anything that you need to build there. So first off, it wants us to check that we have the correct .NET SDK. So let's go ahead and do that. Just make sure we're all set up with this experience. So I'm going to open up a terminal. And once that gets loaded up, I'm going to copy paste. There we go. And boom. As you can see, we have our .NET 6 SDK. And as we kind of mentioned before, this SDK is really kind of an encapsulated experience. So it's in this roaming folder here, which means that it's within this Visual Studio Code environment, but it's not a system-wide install.
Oh, that's cool. So that way, if you're like on a non-admin machine, it's sort of controlled.
Exactly, exactly. So let me go back to our Blazor tutorial. So it wants me to open a folder called Blazor app. So I'm going to go ahead and do that in here. So I'm going to file, open a folder. All right. I'm going to do it in my desktop. Name it Blazor app because that's what the module told me to do. And select that. I'm not going to save. And now it's going to boot up this folder here. All right, great. In my folder, what's next? It wants me to create a Blazor server app. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Once again, I'm opening the terminal. I'm within my Blazor app folder. So now I'm going to create that app once it allows me to.
So you really have like a full environment set up, everything that you need. And while it is in that, you know, area that you said, you are still accessing things outside of it, like your desktop.
Exactly. So although it is kind of an, as I've said, encapsulated experience, you really have access to do and build all the things that you could want to build with .NET. So here's my Blazor server app. As you can see, I've got my program.cs, I've got my pages, and they're all here within VS Code. So if I wanted to run this app, just to show you what that looks like, I can just do .NET run. And let's see what happens. So it's going to build it.
So this is kind of nice because if you're already, you know, if you've never used obviously VS Code and .NET, the module is sort of walking you through this experience, but the education pack kind of brings it all together into one place.
Exactly. So the MS Learn content is really expansive, and it's great that now we have a place where all of that can be done, you know, just after one quick install. So all of this, you can go from not having VS Code at all to now having all the tools you need to then create a Blazor app. So let me go ahead and do this, control click. I'm going to continue to localhost to show you what's going on here. And boom, your first Blazor app. And it's just because, and it's all done just with the coding pack and some great content from MS Learn.
Awesome. That's really cool to see it all come together and that you can just start coding right now, hence the coding pack.
Yeah, exactly. It's a really great, easy getting started experience. And something I'm really excited for students to get to use and not have to worry about setting up everything on their own.
Very cool. I love it. I love that not only was it some cool stuff built into the coding pack, but also being able to download more content and actually build real things. That's so cool.
Exactly. Yeah, we've really thought about this as an experience, but also as a stepping off point to be able to then build more apps of all different kinds.
Oh, very cool. Awesome. Well, Katie, thank you so much for coming out and showing this all off. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you so much, James. It's been a blast.
And I'll put show notes links down to the bottom of everything that Katie showed off today, to the education pack, to Microsoft Learn, to just normal getting started stuff, and to the video of all the different learning resources as well. Katie, thank you so much again for coming on. I really appreciate it.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Thanks everyone for tuning in. And don't forget to smash that like button if you're over on YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe as well, so you get updates every single week right here on YouTube and over on Microsoft Docs. Really appreciate your time, and I appreciate all of you for tuning in every single week. And be sure to check all of our live streams. Head over to live.net for more, and I'll put links in the show notes below. So until next time, I'm James Montemagno, and this has been On.net.